Can you guys hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Ah, good morning, it's good to see you.
Building by in reality, right? And another
objective was that we wanted to make sure to exchange knowledge and experiences within, let's say, a peer group of experts working in the field of decision analysis, probabilistic modeling, and probabilistic analysis, and of course, structural health monitoring. And this was to identify what could be termed best practices on how to value structural health monitoring. And then we would like also the joint committee to take steps for formalizing and proposing on how to regulate the use or the application of structural health monitoring in practice, and of course, as always, contribute to a broader dissemination, training and education of students and professionals working in the field. And as we all know, the proposal was successful, and this is a very, very, very good achievement of the people involved. So we need to remember that, and without mentioning all the names, just really acknowledge the people who made this possible. All those who contributed to developing the proposal. When it comes to the particular aims of our consultation from the Memorandum of Understanding with respect to Task 1, Working Group 1, responsibilities, it was stated that we wanted to unify and clarify the theory in view of its application in the context of structural health monitoring, and we wanted to identify and formulate the value of information problems for a given set, a given selection of real world, not work applications, but world applications, and also, and that was a very important aspect, namely to increase the understanding of the theory in a broader circle of experts. And the idea of that was that we should build a platform for further research and developments in the field for the future. And we also specified a few milestones, and of course the milestones are important when we are looking back to see how far did we go. Did we actually achieve what we wanted from the beginning? And we have a few metrics on the scoreboard when we formulated the project, and we highlighted that scientific publications of the theoretical framework was an important aspect. Likewise, is the dissemination at relevant international conferences, special session organization at the conferences and workshops, and also we had the ambition to provide a summary of the theoretical framework, and we said that we wanted to publish this on our website after the end of the project. So let's have a look at where did we go? How far did we come? With respect to methodology, I think that across the course action on the different aspects of the development of methodology, in general, we have come quite far. With respect to Working Group 1, Task 1, I also think that this is the case in several perspectives. So we have definitely identified decision context where value of information analysis within the umbrella of structural health monitoring or integrity management, where such analysis are relevant. We have established a methodical framework, identified some useful value of information formulations, also pointed to the role of indicators. The vehicle between the data which can be observed and their significance, their role in the overall probabilistic modeling of the performance of structures over their service life. We also have pointed at different tools, and a lot has been going on the side of examples to show how to use the different approaches in different contexts. Of course, all of these contributions, first of all, they're not completely covering the entire domain, but they are covering some of the important parts of the domain we have had in focus. It could also be so from the, more critical perspective, I think it's fair to say that maybe most of these methodical components, which we also have provided in this course section, they have already been available for some time in different contexts, slightly different formulated, and presented with a different, different emphasis depending on the context where they are presented. But it's not that we have come up with groundbreaking new knowledge on these aspects. But what we have done is that we have identified the different important components and identified and formulated frameworks in the particular context of cultural risk monitoring or integrity management. And we have, my opinion, achieved significant clarity in this domain. Also, and this has been a very, this has been a lot of hard work for all of us and you, especially. Namely that we have managed to achieve a high degree of consensus on what value of information analysis actually is in the context of cultural risk monitoring. And I think this is maybe one of the most significant outputs of this project. We have a platform which facilitates more efficient future work in the area where we are avoiding a range of possible misunderstandings, which apparently and unfortunately were the case even among experts before the post-action started. We have looked at the different types of decision situations or contexts where value of information in cultural risk monitoring could provide or could have some significance. The one domain, one context, is what we formulated as in-device warning measures to allow for loss reduction in situations where structures and systems get more structures due to accumulated damage or extreme load gains performed on the line. So this, I would say, this is one of the main areas where our formulations, our frameworks fit into quite well. And we have had some focus on this type of application. Then, of course, also for what concerns the optimization of maintenance strategies for structures, we have had a lot of contributions in this direction within the action and a lot of focus on formulating value of information analysis for this particular type of application. Having said that, I need to underline that we have had a focus on individual structures in the action for this type of problem here. And we have somehow not found the energy or the we have not seen maybe we have too much to do in the action, I'll come back to that. but we are not really any focus on portfolios of softwares. And as I have also highlighted a bit later, in that relation, we have also not taken full benefit of the possibility to collaborate with more section 14.06, which concerns the, let's say, the quality management of the built environment for infrastructure systems. Prototype development, some of the things we have done can relate to prototype development, but we have not specifically addressed this particular type of application area. And when it comes to coding, code calibration, the same applies. So these two last mentioned application domains, there's still a lot of work and potential for value of information in these contexts. We have, I think, we have contributed somewhat to maybe make it clear that we need to appreciate that we are dealing with complex systems and that such complex systems, they need adequate representations where we, of course, take into account the various types of services and not least also the systemic uncertainties, because when it comes to the interpretation of information we can collect by means of monitoring, we also have to appreciate that there can be alternative ways of interpreting this information. And such different interpretations may relate to the presence of possible different competing systems. So we observe something. Normally we would associate what we observe with characteristics of the system which we had in our mind. But we need to appreciate that there could be other systems explaining what we have observed. And we have included this in the way we are modeling systems. We have highlighted that the classical engineering approach is what we call a bottom-up approach, but we also need to look at top-down approaches to systems modeling. With respect to that, which I come back to in closing remarks, maybe we have not done enough, but we have done a lot. The formulation of the decision problems also accounts for the possibility that there are different systems which can explain what we observe from monitoring. And we have formulated decision problems also including terms like options analysis, where we over time buy options. This is what we do when we are planning for collection of information and using structural and monitoring. And we have formulated the optimization problems with respect to collection of information accordingly here in this type of formulation. We are looking at normal prior material decision analysis, where we have the possibility that there are different systems to be managed. We don't normally say which one, we can model it holistically. And here we do that under the envelope of value of information analysis. So I think our fundamental formulations are more or less as general as they can be at all. And that's quite good. When it comes to achievements in the dimension of dissemination, I think this has been a very active action we have been working in with more than piece design, TV journal or conference papers, mainly in special sessions and international conferences, and also a vast amount of the fact sheets produced, which are also available for the homepage. There have been several PhD students conducted in short-term scientific missions, both with the purpose to engage the young researchers, but also, as we have seen in several cases, older researchers who have wanted a little bit of time off to get into the matters of failure of information analysis, and that has also contributed significantly to the network, which has been established in this conversation. A very substantial network between peers working on the same interest. This is fantastic. It's a little bit difficult to associate the dissemination outputs specifically to the individual working groups. And I also think it's relevant at all. I think we should just appreciate the enormous dissemination which we have had in this section here, including many other vehicles or instruments than the neighbors, which were the, let's say, the main instrument we had in mind originally. So we had, with the help of people like Maria Kia, via Facebook, we are always dealing with new messages. We are very, very visible in our own community and in the Indian community altogether. So a big congratulations to all of you on this. With respect to how to wrap it up, focus on working group one. The way I see it, it would be really nice if we could develop at least two additional documents, and also, as has been proposed, maybe we could also consider to develop some sort of animation or cartoon. Now, what am I talking about? The one purpose is to address professionals. People with a formal training facilitating a relatively easy understanding of the concepts of valuable information and structural health monitoring. And what I'm aiming at here is really to have a comprehensive but the shortest possible and also to the extent feasible in a generic form. First of all, storytelling around our framework for value of information analysis and structural health monitoring. And then is, let's say, the basic ingredients of the theoretical basis for value of information analysis, the a library of relevant probabilistic models for monitoring information for the indicators which we are using in our analysis. And then, to the extent relevant, also describe particular tools which are relevant when we are doing regular information analysis in the context of structural integrity management. But also for layman, that means people without formal training, and we are thinking about some sort of document which can actually be read by anybody in society or the general public, but also decision makers who may not have, let's say, the mathematical basis training to understand the theory. So at least it should be possible to understand the concepts from such a document. I think such a document has been denoted or talked about in the whole section
such document, but it has not yet materialized. And such document may also be supported by maybe some sort of animation, a video, or a couple of illustrated and design tools. So I think such two documents are still missing. And the respect to the first one, I think what we should do is that we should carry that task into the German Committee on Traffic Safety, and then make sure that that document is finalized there, and it will then become part of the probabilistic model code, and of course it will also end up on the course action homepage in due time. The latter document, I think we should really try to produce here within the last period of the course action. So I think this is an outstanding task, and it could easily be a working group one who should take responsibility for doing that. So lesson learned. I think we all have to appreciate that the experience from this course action is that the concept of value of information seems to be difficult to grasp, even for professionals and experts. And I think that a part of the reason for that is that we have, let's say, different starting points and different terms for the same things in many cases, and that adds to some confusion in our discussions, and also especially in the beginning of the course action, and this is typically in all collaborations between experts, that there's always this tendency that we tend in the first hand to agree with what our colleagues are saying. So if we hear an explanation, even though we may not understand completely the details in this explanation, we tend to agree and not ask any deeper. Now that situation was also what happened in our course action, and it was not until, I believe, a workshop which we had in Munich, or a meeting we had in Munich, that we really started to dig deeper in our scientific exchanges, and that added substantially to the joint understanding of what we were working with. I think this was some sort of turning point, and of course we could still improve on this aspect, but it simply took a lot of time. And from the beginning, that issue was grossly underestimated from my side. What is the good side of this observation? Well, the good side is that apparently what we decided to focus on seems a justified seemed to be fully justified, because there was a strong need for establishing a more broad understanding of the concept. That's clear. But it's also a good news that there's a lot more work to be done. And there are still plenty of topics to work on. So we will have many opportunities to do things together in the future as well. So this is fantastic. We would maybe also have done more, and I think this also points to the future, on addressing information management. The information management around the structural integrity.
things and software that's coming on. So our focus is traditionally very, very much directed on the presentation of the information of particular relevance to the understanding of the performance of the structures, of the structural systems and the infrastructure which we are which we want to monitor and for which we want to understand the value of information which can be collected by monitoring. So we have a very strong focus on the information of particular relevance in the formulation of the probabilistic models of the structural performances and also the understanding of the information which can be collected by one. This is our focus. But there's a much bigger context where this information is just part of, and this is the entire context of the decision processes around the social integrity management. And I think for the future, maybe we really need to address the context and the information management in this context once more. One particular issue here, which I would like to focus on, is the gap, which we also have talked about in discussion. So the gap between recommendations from experts on how to use structural lens monitoring inspections to the owners of the structures or the buildings or the operators of the structures or the buildings, and then what is actually being done. So we have a lot of assumptions on how to optimally collect the information and what to do with the collected information, how that supports effective management. And our recommendations go into the operator owner organizations, and there the reality is very, very often much different for many reasons. As an example, but also other reasons, negligence, for instance, or let's say personal effectiveness, or other issues, lead up to the reality that all these recommendations are actually not fulfilled or they are not followed. So there's a discrepancy between our optimal plans and what is being conducted. And in order to really contribute to the integrity management of the built environment, we need to understand this gap. And maybe also we need to take into account in the strategies that we are proposing and identifying, seen from a robustness perspective. So surely, we want to contribute to the development of robust schemes for structural risk management, right? And here, one possibility is to use data mining, big data analysis, to try to establish the understanding of such discrepancies between optimal plans and actually executed structural risk monitoring. And also, I also want to point at data mining when we're looking at the performance of the portfolios of structures, and also when we want to take benefit of data collected over very large numbers of structures covering aspects of learning codes and codification for social responsibility. Conclusions. I think, as I indicated a few times, that we definitely have reached the objectives we set out to accomplish. At the time we formulated the project, it was we didn't have the same level of detailing in the way we looked at the value of information analysis in the context of social risk monitoring as we have now. Now, of course, we can also point at many things we did not do, but in the beginning we realized what could be done in all corners of the domain. The quest was surely more demanding than I envisioned. I think many of us have been surprised, not least, as I mentioned, with respect to the change in understanding of the concepts and finding common understandings. It's also fair to say that we have not completely, on all accounts, really managed to transform theory and methodology into something which could be termed operational procedures, so procedures which can actually be used directly on all sorts of technical management problems which are relevant. Much more can be done. And I think that not least the recent base collapse in Yale point to those where the present cost action achievements may actually contribute to safe and more efficient safe management of structures, but also on the aspects where we need to work much more, namely to ensure that recommendations made with respect to structural risk monitoring in the context of integrity management is accounted for and also regulated in a way that we have robust decision making. And that brings me to the final slide, namely outreach. And my position is that we and you around the table should try to establish a task group which will work after the finalization of our course action and bring the results of the course action into the joint committee on structural safety so that we may ensure that the results will have impact both on mid to long term concerning evaluation of structural performances. That was mid and long term, but we also have a task to accomplish in the ongoing additions of the Eurocodes, and this task group that we are suggesting to establish should also pick up that ball, that challenge, and immediately find a way to engage in the ongoing discussions on how structural risk monitoring could and should enter into the revised human rules. And then, let's say, on the research side and the broader networking side, I think it would be relevant, for instance, to consider Marie-Corinne ITN project for the education of PhD students, bringing really the built environment integrity management into technology 4.0 on the obvious platform of doing that, the psychophysical scheme for supporting decisions, maybe using the concept of value of information structural health monitoring as the main vehicles for bringing the built environment into technology forwards and zero. So thanks for your attention, and I hope that the information which was
spend still through the interview, despite the low quality of the sound and maybe also not the delivery quality of the speaker, had some value altogether. Thank you.
Thank you.